There's been a lot of talk in the press in recent weeks about trans athletes, and another YouTuber put up a video a week ago. A lot of people sent me links to it. This woman has a channel, science channel, discombobulating science or whatever. I forget the name of the channel. but she put up a video where she broke down the debate, the trans athlete debate. I thought she did a good job on that video, but what she did not offer in the video was a solution to the problem, which I definitely have. I haven't chimed in on this, but it really all stems, I mean, this chapter of the debate stems from a single athlete, a single college athlete who is was trying to compete and got banned for trying to compete in a swimming competition. So really controversy comes around one person. The idea of being banned from competition based on biology came up a few years ago when a woman who was a runner got banned from competition because her endocrinology, that is her hormone panel, didn't pass mustard, even though it was found out that she was, you know, she's a biological female, but she just produces like an immense amount of testosterone, which they found out in studies, most female athletes do have unusually high levels of testosterone and other and growth hormone and other endocrinological abnormalities for females. I mean, sports is, like that woman who made that video says, sports is a freak show. That's the whole point. Sports is a collection of people who are freaks of nature doing competitions, competing with each other, with competing with other freaks of nature, you know. And the thing about banning someone because you fear their competitiveness or their abilities, it, on one hand, it shows the stupidity of sports as a thing. I personally don't like sports. I don't participate in sports. So I can understand people liking it, but the religiosity around competitive sports, and especially the idea of keeping women's sports pure, is ridiculous. It's just stupid. But I'm not gonna spend half an hour busting the chops of sports. But the solution to the trans athlete issue is so simple, and it's done in many sports today, and that's weight classes. That's it, weight class. It's done in boxing, it's done in weightlifting. You never put a welterweight in a ring with a heavyweight, because everyone knows how that will end. That's why they have weight classes in boxing and many other competitive sports. So why not have weight classes in competitive swimming or track and field competitions? Why not have weight classes? I argue that if you put weight classes into these competitions where people fear trans athletes, very specifically trans women competing with biological women, no one gives a crap if trans men compete with other biological men. No one gives a crap about trans people in men's sports. It's only, you know, maintaining the sanctity and purity of women's sports that's got everyone's panties in a bunch. And the solution is simple. It's just weight classes. Why not have weight classes for something like swimming? No. The reason I know this is the solution is that imagine how many more people would enter a highly competitive field like competitive swimming if you had weight classes. Because most women wouldn't compete in swimming because they would not meet the minimum weight requirements for it. They'd be too small or too lean. They wouldn't have enough body weight to be able to compete with even just the average swimmer. So what if they had their own class? What if you had weight classes in swimming? And then it's not a matter of worrying about if the unfairness is coming from one trans woman entering a competition when the entire sport itself is inherently unfair, because if you're a 75, 80 pound woman, you can't compete in a regular competitive swimming match because the average female swimmer you're swimming against is like twice your body weight and strength. So you don't even stand a chance. You can't even begin to compete. But if you had your own weight class at 100, 120 pounds, then you would compete with other swimmers in your weight range. And that solves all problems. It's not a debate of whether or not trans people should be in women's sports. That's just ridiculous. It's about weight class. It's the idea that you have a heavyweight competitor in with the welterweights. It's just that simple. So you divide it by weight classes, and then it's fair. You don't have to discriminate against anybody based on who they are or where they come from. You simply make it an even competition based on a range of body weight, like they do in so many other sports. Why is this a revelation? Why isn't it a no-brainer? Because although, you know, boxing, weightlifting have had weight classes forever, these other competitions, the idea of having weight classes is abhorrent. Why? With swimming alone, imagine how many tens of thousands of people, men and women, would begin to participate in swimming as a sport if they had their own weight class. Because most people can't pass the mustard to even compete because they're not even like of the build to compete with regular cis women, much less trans women. So why not have weight classes where thousands of people, tens of thousands of young people who can't even begin to compete because, like basketball, if you're 4'11", you're never getting on a collegiate basketball team. That's discriminatory, sure, but it's baked into the sport. Discrimination is baked into all sports. If you weigh 110 pounds, you're not gonna get a scholarship to be on a collegiate football team. The bias is baked in for body size, body type. Like I said, sports is a competition of freaks of nature. And the idea that whenever a freak of nature comes that's like a really great freak of nature that's better than everyone else, well, it's just like when you win at a casino. You know, everyone loves to go to casinos. Everyone loves to gamble. Well, I don't gamble, even though I could. But the one thing you can't do at a casino is win. If you go to a casino and you win all the time, the human tanks descend upon you and you get taken to a back room, and then you don't go back there and gamble anymore. Because the one thing you cannot do at a casino is win. Which is why I do not go to casinos to play blackjack, like people say, "Oh, Fran, you showed how great you are at blackjack, and you know you win at blackjack really well. Why don't you just make a living going to casinos?" Well, you can't make a living going to casinos and playing blackjack, because if you always win blackjack, you're not at the casino very long. So that's the thing about sports. It's like you get one person who is like extremely good at a sport or is extremely endowed physically, and then you just ban them from the sport because they're just, we like our freaks of nature moderately freakish, but if you're too good a freak of nature, then you're just banned from the sport altogether. That's really what they did to that woman, you know. Make weight classes if you think it's unfair. Weight classes. Simple solution. You could do it today if you wanted to, but you won't, because you'd rather bitch and moan about this and that. Shouldn't be about anything else. Mic drop. But, you know, this debate, people think of this as a new debate, but it's not. It goes back decades. Back in the 70s when Renee Richards suddenly appeared in the women's tennis circuit in California. Was it La Jolla, where she just creamed everybody and won? And everyone was like, well, who is this woman? Where does she come from? How come we've never heard of her before? And when it broke that Renee Richards was formerly a doctor from New York State who had competed in the men's competitions and won before, then they were banned. And irony of ironies, Martina Navratilova, when she defected to the U.S., Renee Richards became her coach and was her coach for years, maybe a decade, but it was throughout the 70s, 80s, was Martina Navratilova's coach. And then, as a twist to this, recently Martina comes out saying how she's against trans women competing with biological women. So it's like, wow. So there you go. Why not weight classes in tennis then? I mean, Billie Jean King showed that, you know, she kicked that guy's ass, you know? Women can compete against men if they're of similar body weight. I think that's been proven time and time again in sports. Gender's got nothing to do with it. If it's about sports and skill, it's all about body weight. And yeah, people can say, oh, it's about testosterone and this and that, but, you know, women who are athletes have unusual endocrinology. They don't have the same endocrinology as women who are not athletic. This has been shown. It's been proven. Which is why occasionally biological women get booted off of competition because they're a little too good. They just have a little too much juice. Completely natural, but they're just generating too much juice. And then it's like, well, you can't compete in this competition anymore because we like our freaks of nature moderately freaky, and you're just a little too freaky and I got a little too much juice, so we're just gonna ban you. It happens every few years. A woman gets kicked out because she's just got, her endocrinology is just a little too rich, running a little too rich, and she gets banned. But it just proves that sports is stupid. And trying to put purity tests and anything on into sports about who can compete and what things, and trying to say, oh, it's this or that, is just, it's idiotic. The bias is baked into all sports. Every sport has its own biases, and they're all physical requirements, weight requirements, baked in.
At the bench again.